Quidditch keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they?
everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sport.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play?
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
And this is caught at the 8. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. A good pickup there of 20 yards. Looking to throw. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well, and every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Second and goal. They still need 8 yards. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. First down, he'll drop to throw it, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Vikings holding the football. They're looking at a 3rd and 6 here to start things out. To it through the contact. Incomplete. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they're coming off a 3 and out, my friend.
Then they got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before and realize it hasn't worked.
Go to someone else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
First down, here's the run with Cook. A swift move and then tackled just on the other side of midfield. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They got to feel pretty good about that one.
He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, a 22. That is caught at the 7. And a big tackle there as the defender runs right through it at the 7-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. Second down now after the incompletion. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. More from Minneapolis after this. Back now. As I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlight. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked fearless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Offense in a good spot here, second and 2. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one.
Start this drive in the air. Throwing right, and that's complete. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Our first look at the NFL scoreboard comes from Green Bay. Early lead in that one for the Packers. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. Going right side here, and that's complete. 4 seconds left, and there's the timeout. In field goal range and a chance to tackle.
come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. They'll look to throw now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
It's complete to Diggs. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being...
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing.
And the pressure gets to him again.
Now, that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football. Led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Well, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
They're going to look to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. That one goes for 24 yards. Back to throw now on first down. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over...
He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next...
Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. Brandon, it's all about pace and tempo now for them. They've got the advantage, so I'm going to put musical terms for you. You don't want to go prestissimo. That's too quick, too lively, right? But you also...
And the giant rush gets home as down he goes.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Back to throw here. Pressure gets to him, and down he goes. Back at the four-yard line. And out now come the Vikings. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you'd think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
And his throw here is incomplete.
And it is true, you can draft the fastest, you can draft the most athletic guys, but if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second, would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads, took him right off his feet. A gain of 7, and they pick up the first.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down, got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. And a quick throw here, that's complete. So a good spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little gain. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. And at this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch.
All right, here we go.
Hand off comes to Cook. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop. 1:50 left in the football game. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They run it again with Cook. And an alley to run. Touchdown, Vikings. A great effort there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead. And now out comes Minnesota. Getting down to the end here, they have a 2-score lead. Barely, but it's a 2-score lead, so that probably makes you as a coach feel a lot more comfortable right now, doesn't it, Charles?
It does, but it doesn't mean now you go out and run option or some kind of wild double reverse or anything like that. But you do know that if anything does go haywire, you're still in control of this game.
I want a double reverse, don't you?
I'm just waiting for that day where we actually see something like that in this situation.
We'll see what happens here. Again, it's Cook. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. The Vikings on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense.
Well, I know at points in this...